Number 10, the Trump ad. While running for president, your public image is everything. To support themselves, many presidential runners create political ads describing why they would be the best president ever and that you should vote for them. To compensate for other runners' advertising, many politicians create and receive attack ads. And of course, Donald Trump has been on the butt end before. Perhaps you've seen the ad already. It's basically a bunch of women reading quotes said by Donald Trump that put down women. If there was an ad about you and all the things you said, you'd want to see it, right? Well, Trump has apparently seen the ad as he told ABC, well, you know, I have seen it. But not even 5 minutes later, Trump speaks to NBC about the ad and says, I have not seen the ad, so I would have to see it. But that doesn't make sense. He just said he's seen it, and now he says he hasn't. It's hard for anyone to justify this one because, unlike other contradictions that take place days or years in between, this one was 2 minutes apart. It doesn't even make sense to lie about whether you've seen it or not. This is just another famous example of Trump's inconsistencies. Number 9. Iowa. When running for president, representative, or any position of power, you need to gain the support of the people who got you there. For someone in Trump's position, you need the support of the states, the cities, and the people. So when Trump made a speech thanking the people of Iowa by saying things like, I love you people, and I love you Iowa, that really made the people there confident in who they were going to vote for. But of course, it's never that easy with Trump. Later on during a speech, he goes on a rant saying, how stupid are the people of Iowa? One could say he was just trying to be funny, but his tone and the way he goes about it clearly says he's serious. So pro tip here, don't insult your supporters. Number 8, number 1 consultant. A man like Donald Trump must make many important decisions throughout the day, both now during his presidential run and even before when his main focus was his multi-million dollar empire. With so many decisions on such a wide variety of topics, one would think that Trump needs someone to talk to. You know, someone to make sure he's making the right decisions. Trump is quoted as saying, I do listen to people. I hire experts. I hire top people. And I do listen. This makes complete sense to any logical person. Full credit to Trump for hearing other people's opinions on his decisions. And possibly averting making a whole bunch of mistakes. With that in mind, he later, reinstates that, I'm speaking with myself, number one, because I have a very good brain. My primary consultant is myself. Well, I guess that explains why most of the stuff he says sounds like it's straight out of Mein Kampf. Had Trump actually stayed with his first way of thinking, I'm fairly sure that his presidential campaign would not be where it is today. Take that how you will. Number 7, Megyn Kelly. Hey, don't get us wrong. We know that talking to reporters isn't easy. But when you're on TV, it's kind of an unspoken rule that you should attempt to be polite to those who speak to you, even if the reporters and newscasters aren't the most popular people in the world. So when Trump was asked to be interviewed by Megyn Kelly, he of course agreed. And to his credit, he was mostly more or less respectful to her during the interview. When she asked him if he thinks he can do a better job than she can, Trump said, I could never beat you. You've done a great job. I mean it. That's fairly polite of Trump, even though he could have been arrogant beforehand. But of course, he couldn't let himself be known for a compliment. Months later, when asked about Megyn Kelly, Trump said, I don't think she's very good at what she does. I think she's highly overrated. So close. He almost complimented someone without going back on it. Maybe one day. Number 6, motivations. It's very important that one has a firm belief in what they're doing. A runner's motivation on its own can in fact sway a voter, if they show that they're genuine to that cause. So when asked about his motivations for running for president, Trump said, I wanted to do this for myself. He didn't want to look back in 10 years and regret not giving it a shot, which is respectable. You never know until you try, right? So his motivation at the time seemed solid, even if he didn't specify he wanted to make America better or anything. Months later, Trump was asked a similar question, to which he responded by saying, I don't want it for myself. I don't need it for myself, for my ego. I just think I'd do a great job. Wait a minute. I thought you were doing this for you. Now it's for us? You know, it's really hard to relate to someone whose opinion changes every couple months. Number 5. Self-funding. Running for an election isn't cheap. There's advertisements, people, travel, and dozens of other things that need to be paid for. Money is of course important, which is why most runners collect donations and do fundraising so they'll be able to do the best they can. Trump is no exception to this rule, except for the fact that on many occasions he said, I'm self-funding my campaign, so I don't have any pressure. It's a very modest claim, but unfortunately it became an utter lie. Not long after saying this, Trump's campaign began accepting donations to compete with Hillary Clinton. The fact that he vowed he wouldn't take donations for so long and then went back on it makes the original statement utterly pointless. Number 4. Ted Cruz. Friendly competition is never a bad thing, such as when you're playing sports against your friends, or even playing some good old-fashioned video games. Well, here are two people who are in the same party, Donald Trump and Ted Cruz. Since the two are both running for president, they of course had to run against each other, but of course they tried to keep it friendly, at first. Trump even went as far as saying, "I love Ted Cruz, great guy." That's a nice sentiment to your opponent, wouldn't you say? Well, it was nice at the time. Of course, Trump later changes his opinion on his adversary when he said nobody likes Ted Cruz once they get to know him. Well, there goes all the healthy competition. And I guess we can assume that Trump didn't know Ted Cruz very well when their campaigns began. Of course, Cruz attempted to bash Trump back, but at this point, everyone and their mother bashes Trump. And it doesn't seem to work very well. Number 3. Gay marriage. Nowadays, most first world countries widely accept gay marriage. Not all, but a good chunk have legalized it in recent years. It's come a long way, and it's people who stood up and believed in equal rights that allowed it to happen. Most people, even if they accept it around them, have a very strong opinion on it one way or another. All the way back in 2000 and long before his run for presidency, Trump said the institution of marriage should be between a man and a woman. For that time period, this thinking wasn't all too uncommon. And although it's hard to hear, it was pretty conventional. 5 years later, it seems he changed his mind. As in respect to Elton John's gay wedding, he said that if two people dig each other, they dig each other. It's fair to say that someone's opinion could change in 5 years, and this is a positive change, so why not? Unfortunately, jumping forward to modern presidential candidacy days, Trump is back on the whole marriage is between a man and a woman bandwagon. Again. For someone who claims to be against gay marriage, he's having a hard time keeping his opinion straight. Number 2. Pro-choice or pro-life? There's no joke to be made here. Abortion is a very sensitive topic for the average person, and even worse for politicians. Some presidents and prime ministers don't even want to bring up the topic in hope of keeping the fires at bay. Despite this, you can bet that every single one of them has a side, even if they don't want to express it. Trump has one too, like everyone else. He said that he's very pro-choice. I hate the concept of abortion, and later continuing that he is strongly for choice, and yet, hates the concept. A fair stance, admissible of it, regardless of how he feels himself. As is very common for Trump, he later changed his mind and stated that he's very, very proud to say that I'm pro-life. Though abortion may not be the hot topic right now, it's still something that people care about. One can't just jump back and forth between them. If so, you lose credibility on both sides. But Trump should be fine since, you know, he rarely says anything that could ruin his credibility and public image, right? Number 1. Presidential candidacy. Our good friend Donald Trump is one to keep his word, is he not? Well, in 1987, Trump claimed that he has no intention of running for president. Now, you could say that people change, especially since that was 30 years ago, but either way, that's a very bold statement to make, and one that Trump seemed very adamant in keeping. Yet, here we are, 2016, and Donald Trump is running for the presidential seat. Unlike other times where he simply insults people when they aren't there, or just saying whatever he feels like in the heat of the moment, this is far, far bigger. And depending on how you wish to vote, for some people, a far worse contradiction. Many people, including those who don't even live in America, probably wish that Trump had kept that mentality. He seemed to make smarter remarks back then too. If only, slightly smarter.